I was reading what is probably going to be anime of the year, aka Chainsaw Man.
Oh god, yeah, that trailer okay, dropped and okay, had like 10 million views on Twitter.
Yeah.
Oh
yeah,
my gosh.
I mean, if we're going to talk about a trailer that made me nut, that's a trailer
that
made me
nut. Oh yeah, that trailer definitely, like, yeah. I was like, knew what they were doing.
I was like,
yeah.
MAPPA, you son of a bitch.
You son of a bitch.
You son of a bitch, MAPPA, you did it again.
Wait, yeah, so what, MAPPA were doing Attack on Titan, right? And I saw all those comments that people were like, oh, why couldn't they animate Attack on Titan like this? What's going on?
Well, do you remember the first Attack on Titan season 4 trailer? It looked fucking amazing.
Yeah.
But like compared to the final product.
That's what I'm scared of.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm very scared of.
We also learned from like when Ken came on the podcast, shout out to that episode.
Yeah.
He was telling us, you know, it's not really about the studio. It's about the guy in charge and who he brings on.
Yeah, it's about the director and the team of animators. Yeah.
So, you know, if you have good connections and you can bring someone on, almost feel like the studio almost doesn't matter sometimes. It's a slight indication, but I feel like it's so inconsistent.
No,
yeah, I mean, it's definitely, a lot of it has got to do with the team behind it and the director behind it. I mean, we just talked about Jujutsu Kaisen, also by MAPPA, that was like such a well-animated show, even compared to like other MAPPA shows. Mm. I think that's just mostly because of the team behind it.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping that Chainsaw Man gets a good adaptation. I haven't even read the fucking manga.
Well, I reread the manga when the trailer dropped.
You know when you have those shows or those you know, properties, I don't know what you call them.
IPs
where you just know they're going to be bangers. Yeah. And so you're not like in a rush to jump into it. You're like, I know I've got something coming.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Got a little present under the Christmas tree. I can unwrap it anytime. You know, it's there. you need like a 10 out of 10 in the waiting, just in case.
Yeah,
and exactly. That's definitely mine right now. Yeah. I'm like, I know it's coming.
I'm also honestly.
It's airing this fall, right? Chainsaw Man?
I think it's either this year or early next year.
Fuck, this year, Jesus. Like this year doesn't need another good anime. My fucking God, it's getting too much now. Much to watch. Do you think that Chainsaw Man getting released this year is going to reach the same heights as like Jujutsu Kaisen?
I want it to. As a fan of the manga, I want this to be talked about more.
Yeah, I have a feeling it definitely has that potential now. It's been a long time since I've seen people hype up this one IP this much.
Yeah.
Like I remember watching the trailer and the trailer just like, it felt like the trailer just broke the fucking anime Twitter for the day. Like it got like a million views in a day on Twitter or something,
it's
right?
Like less than a day.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Which it's is almost like, got like a million likes, like the actual tweet.
That's crazy.
Which is fucking nuts for an anime trailer.
It did not fall off, did not get ratioed.
No, it did not. It ratioed every other anime trailer.
Yeah. For sure.
I just hope like the hype doesn't collapse in on itself and everyone starts watching it and people are just like, oh, this wasn't as good as
what I was expecting. Yeah, that's what I'm really scared of. I really hope MAPPA like actually pulls through with how good the trailer
was. I don't see
why
we have any reason to doubt MAPPA.
I don't doubt MAPPA. But
bro, MAPPA are just like collecting the Infinity Stones.
Yeah, they are.
Massive IPs.
They're killing it right now.
Attack on Titan, Jujutsu Kaisen, fucking Chainsaw Man.
Yeah, like, that's true.
Yeah. Have you watched Chainsaw Man?
Yeah, I'm 9 episodes in.
I like it so far.
It's something, man.
I'm
kind of glad that we finally got a show that was hyped and so far has been following through.
Yeah.
Like every episode is a delight. Mm-hmm. It's fucking weird.
It's just insane. Every episode is like a movie budget. Like
it's a lot.
Crazy.
The fact that there's a different ending every time as well. Yeah. Like it's kind of insane. I am blown away.
Anime 2023 is fucking sweating.
Yeah.
Oh fuck, we got to live up to that.
It's kind of crazy. Even as like, even if I wasn't a fan of the show, it's like you watching it, you're like, you just can't not be amazed by it. Like even if you don't enjoy it.
It's fucking insane.
Story.
Yeah.
Like the story is crude sometimes, but I like it. I think it's fun.
I mean, I like it's, it's obviously a bit edgier than like a lot
for
of
sure,
like other
for
shonen,
sure. It feels
but
like edgy.
Yeah, but I don't
times.
Feel like it's like edgy for the sake of being like edgy, which we see with like some other shows, you know, where it's just like, oh, this is the show that's aimed towards 15-year-olds that, you know, want to think they're watching something adult. You know?
No, it's clearly just like Fujimoto just being like, I don't give a fuck if people like this or not. Like, this is just how I'm going to make my story and how I'm going to make my characters.
I
was kind of amazed at one point in episode 9, the episode before ends with this scene and then they reuse the scene in the next episode, but they reanimate it very slightly, entirely over again. And I'm like, okay, now that's too much. That's just a waste. Like, this is insane, but this is like, what? Yeah. And it's all insane animation. Like yeah. It's like, I don't understand how much money or time power, cost me money again, I got in trouble. Like and the amount of time, money and effort put into this must be another level. Like yeah. The amount of talent that must've gone into this is insane.
Mm-hmm. What blows my mind is when, you know, when people like look at something and think good animation, they think, oh, the fight scene was like good. Or they think of the fight scene. Like Chainsaw Man just looks good in like every single
talking,
second.
The talking scenes.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God, it's so fucking, every shot is so like dynamic, yeah. Right? It's like, you know, sometimes you watch an anime, it's just like always like, oh, basic shot for shot for shot. Mm. There always feels like there's some thought put into how this looks on film. And
it's like what
that.
Angle have we not put a camera at yet? God. Wait, let's do yeah. it. Let's do it from there.
God, yeah. I know you've read the manga, but you need to watch the anime, man.
I am watching it.
Oh, you are watching
yeah,
it as well?
Of course. I kind of have to. Like, I don't. I think I would actually be hung and quartered if I didn't watch it.
The anime is so good that I'm yeah. like, I really don't want to touch the manga. I'm like, this is insane.
It's so good.
I know, yeah. I bet it is, but like watching the anime, I'm like, there's no way.
I think this first season's only going to end halfway.
Probably.
Yeah, I think the manga's as good as the anime.
I agree.
I've been doing something like a little quirky. I've been watching the anime, then reading the manga.
And oh, okay.
Shut the fuck up, God. Don't fucking say that shit to me. Why the fuck did you do that?
Why would you do that?
Why?
Because why did that? Because anime is my medium of choice, if I have a choice. And the anime is doing an amazing production. Mm. But I think Tatsuki Fujimoto, the mangaka, is an absolute fucking genius.
I agree.
He uses manga in a way that no other manga artist, I think, has done. He has such a unique way of conveying like his ideas and emotions. Mm-hmm. And it's a way that is impossible to replicate in any other medium.
He's able to draw it in a way that looks and feels cinematic.
Yeah.
Which
yeah.
I think is really hard to do in the medium of manga. Like, yeah. because you know, again, it's like a lot like with a lot of anime, it's like you have your bog standard, like flow of panels and like, you know, maybe every now and then there'll be an artist that'll be like, oh, I'm gonna draw outside of the panel, like literally outside of the panel to kind of add like dynamic to it. But like Fujimoto just kind of draws it in a way where it's just like, this flows in a really smooth way, but it's also a really strange feeling.
Yeah.
At the same time.
Like now that I've like read like what's been adapted so far and, in the manga, I'm like, how the fuck does Tatsuki Fujimoto have better comedic timing in the manga, which has no comedic timing, than in the anime, right? The job he's done with this, like the way he's like paneled and laid out his page, it like, the scenes in the manga, there are like some funny scenes that are like way funnier, I think, in the manga than in the anime. And it's just because of the way that he's kind of like timed it really well with how like you turn the page and stuff like that.
Do you have any examples that you might be able to think of?
I can't think of off the top of my head.
I just wondered if you did.
Yeah, there's a few things that I think are impossible to translate to the anime. Like one thing I can think of is, how can I say this without spoiling anything that happens? So there is a weapon that involves a nail, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you're like you've
nine. I'm on episode nine.
You're on episode nine. You should have seen it then. There's a weapon that involves a nail.
Maybe
it's like a demon kind of thing, right?
A nail, as in this nail.
As in doom.
Okay. Nail. All right. Okay. Then, no, I haven't.
What's
I don't.
This nail?
I don't. Oh, this nail.
Oh,
I've seen something like that involves this. I haven't seen something that involves this.
No, you have.
You really? Have.
If you're up to episode nine, you have.
You definitely have.
Have I?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Did you think it was a sword?
Maybe it was a sword. Maybe you could I don't know. All right. We'll carry on.
Yeah. But there's a scene where he uses this weapon. And obviously it's a weapon that's like infused with a demon, right?
Yeah.
So there's this like really cool panel where like to use this weapon, you have to have a contract with a devil. That's what every yep. weapon is, right? And so how he portrays that this weapon is controlled by this devil is that you have like the normal panels, and that's how it is mm-hmm. throughout the entire manga, every comic book. And then when he uses this, weapon, a finger just appears from that, goes from like outside of like the box panels, right? Mm-hmm. And so it kind of like flicks from out of frame into frame.
Oh,
and you're like,
that's cool.
Oh, that's really fucking cool to be like, oh, there's something that's being like called out from like outside this world and shit like that. And I'm like, you can't really do that in anime because it's you know, okay. we don't have boxes and shit like that. But it's like small things like that where he really thinks about how do I do something that is really cool that only manga can do. And he does this in not just
like-
You've convinced me. Not just Chainsaw Man, but pretty much everything I've read from him, he does something unique to manga that I've not seen anywhere else. And that's true, especially if you've not read, I would highly recommend Goodbye Eri, which is like a one shot. You can read that within like
that is an hour. So genius.
Yeah. Right. And I was like, I've never read something that is just like so, it's a masterpiece in my mind. So fucking genius. Okay. Yeah.
I mean, Chainsaw Man, I've loved it so far.
Chainsaw Man is great.
It's crazy to see. Because again, we've had hyped up shows, but I don't think we've had a show that's been this hyped up in so long.
I don't think ever.
Yeah. And it's insane to see it kind of meeting it and kind of crushing it.
Because I was a bit worried because I remember watching like the first six episodes. I'm like, this is cool. But it's kind of like your standard affair right now.
Yeah, from episode like 5, 6 onwards, it definitely got way more exciting. And it's been like so fun watching it. But also I'm sad that I have to wait every week.
I'm sad that we're gonna have to wait for a season two.
Yeah,
hopefully.
Is the manga finished?
Part one of the manga is finished. So he's currently writing. So he went on a little bit of a break after part one, and now he's starting up part two again.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I did get a chuckle out of. I guess it's not really a spoiler, but like at one point they're like, the name of a demon is means its strength or something. And they're like, what's the scariest thing? A chainsaw and a gun. And I was like, what? What? You have this like really intensely, like really edgy built up world. And they're like, gun strong.
Yeah, gun strong. Gun strong. Gun devil strong.
I was like, all right. That still doesn't really spoil anything. It's just, it's just a funny bit of like, I was like, what? Yeah.
I've heard things just get more and more intense in the manga as it goes on, though. It's already pretty fucking intense.
I've never watched the show and actually said what the fuck out loud so many times. Just shit happens, you're like, what the fuck?
God, and the second half of the manga is just like that. I believe it. Like the last two or three volumes are just insane. I'm just like, what?
I'm insane. I'm very happy. I'm very excited. Wait, is it 12 episodes they're doing or?
12 episodes.
Fuck, man.
I know.
Bring back the 24.
I know. Bring back the two core.
I'll take the same ending. Let's just get a few more episodes in. Come on, that's like a whole episode of animation we can do. Come on, let's get more episodes. I don't need the ending every time. It's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really hope we don't have to wait too long for another season because
I think we are. I think we are.
It's been a while since I've watched the show and I'm like, 12 episodes, that's it? That's it? 12 episodes?
I've never been bricked up through the entire show like that before.
Yeah.
Like from start to finish. Like the food, I'm rock solid when they show food in the show. The food looks so good.
That's the Mapper effect right there.
I've never been more fucking bricked up watching a hand-holding scene.
Dude, right?
Holy fuck, man. Talk about like awakening something in you. I'm like, I thought this was a meme. I thought hand-holding hentai was a meme, and they actually fucking made it a thing.
Dude,
every character has awoken something in everyone.
I'm impressed that they've managed to make a character who is that horny likable. I figured anyone that horny in real life would in any show, normally for characters just super horny, it's like Meliodas.
Yeah.
I fucking hate them.
Yeah.
They fucking suck.
But that's the thing another thing with Fujimoto that I think is genius is that like, not just Chainsaw Man, but everything he's written, every character is an absolute piece of shit.
Yeah.
But he's somehow able to turn these absolute fucking detestable piece of shit characters likable.
Well, it's like in real life, right? Most people are gray. Like most people do bad things, so they do good things, right? So it's like, if you can kind of channel that, and I feel like that's where it's doing that great. Like it so far, Chainsaw Man, all the characters don't feel like they good, bad, hee hee tee hee. It's like, all right, you know, they're a good person, but maybe they got a lot of problems. Yeah. Maybe they're a bad person, but they do some good things.
But I've also seen a lot of anime where they just like, they try and make like a purposefully shitty character, right?
Yeah.
To be okay, you know, all the edgy people are going to enjoy this one. Yeah. And then it just ends up being extremely annoying.
Yeah, I mean, this could easily be like a Mirai Nikki situation.
Exactly.
Where it's like, haha, edge and good swords.
Haha, everyone is shitty, lol.
Everyone's horny and we're all going to stab each other. And it's like, all right, well.
I think he strikes that perfect balance where he, pretty much every character in Chainsaw Man is kind of like an asshole.
Absolutely.
But it's like an entertaining asshole.
Well, because they're all trying to survive, right?
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, how would you act if you had to survive?
Yeah.
And in this world that is very fucked up.
Yeah, like I remember the scene where they were all like trapped in the building together.
Oh yeah.
And it's just fucking chaos. And I was just like, I was just like, it feels like watching a scene from Always Sunny in Philadelphia. No way. Yeah,
yeah. The gang tries to escape. Yeah,
yeah. The gang tried to escape from
that
a
sounds like a really good edit. That sounds like a good edit.
Because it was just like, why am I having such a good time just seeing these guys try to survive? It's
and they're all bitching and complaining and whining.
Yeah, they're in like a life and death situation and they're just like, it's just fucking bants, man.
Just when Denji's like, I'm going to sleep. It's just like, I fucking love that scene. It's like, bro.
Who's that scene where one of the girls like freaking out and then Power just like starts like burst, like full on burst out laughing. And I was just like, what? It's a fucking riot, man.
So good.
Oh, it's been a long time since I've been this excited for an anime.
I just hope they don't give me a reason to ever dislike the show. So far, I'm pretty happy.
Yeah.
To be honest, nah. I mean, even the second half, as chaotic as it gets, like it's just so intense and insane where it's just like, of course this is how it is.
And I think like the like complaints about CG that I've seen on Twitter are like so far. Overblown.
Oh no, dude! There's like barely any CG, and then when it is, it's like it's good. Like it's well.
I think the most awkward looking shots were like in episode one.
Yeah,
and then like they still use CG in like other fights, and it just they've managed to blend it a lot better. But even in episode one, it was like it looked a bit dodgy here and there, like a few shots, but it didn't look bad. No. You know, I've seen bad CG.
I've seen Exxon. I've seen Exxon. That's bad. Yeah.